What? So you've got some templates. Now what? What do you do with these templates? How do you actually use them in a workflow? So the ISO 19650 workflow with those eight main steps there, ranging from assessment and need to closing out a project, with the swim lanes of the teams that are involved, the appointing party, the owner or the person that is paying the bill, the lead appointed party, the team that is responsible for coordinating everybody, and then the appointed party are different swim lanes inside of this diagram. The first part, appointing somebody to be the information manager. So that function needs to be appointed. And that is key throughout the workflow that we know who is responsible for that, especially within the appointing party. And then hopefully the appointing party has a group of documents that then corresponds to an invitation to tender. So this is the bidding process. And those documents combine into the exchange information requirements that we then get responses from the prospective lead appointed parties. Multiple responses with multiple pre-appointment BIM execution plans with potential risks and mobilization plans that form a response, a tender response, with input from the potential task teams that that lead appointed party has. And then the next part is when you make an appointment. So you're actually saying, I am contracting for this team to actually carry out the project. And we would start to add the responsibility matrix and the master information delivery plan, which is a combination of all of the teams that are doing the work, their task information delivery plans. All of these terminologies, I'm sure, are potentially very foreign to those that are just starting. This will be something that will be reinforced as you use the workflow and use the templates. And then the last parts to this workflow are obviously delivering the project, mobilizing, verifying that you're meeting as you go through each stage in the project, the requirements, and then closing out with the lessons learned. This workflow is supported by Planoly, and we have inside of the plan and the scope modules for this whole section through 1, 2, and 3, the templates to support that. And I see a lot of, yes, there are editable templates that you can use and put in place and invite others to, and we'll take you through this workflow now. Invitation to tender, putting together the organizational, the project, and the asset information requirements into an exchange information requirement, and that becomes the tender. That becomes the set of tender documentation. And Louis, once we've created that, what's important?
Within the platform, you can set up teams to make sure that you can assign what teams are responsible for certain sections and invite team members with certain levels of permission so that they can see certain sections that are ready for them to review. So this is an important step in the workflow to get teams invited to the tender.
And then one of the other parts of this is being able to control what people see. So being able to say which documents people have access to and being able to share only certain parts of it and following the ISO workflow of work in progress, shared and published, we can control that along with settings on the document level as well and assigning sections to specific parties as well.
Yeah, a huge thing about that is consolidating all that information in the same areas that you're building it. Instead of using another platform to communicate and process feedback, you're doing that in the same location.
Absolutely. So after we've had an invite, we then get a response, and the team that's responding really needs to get involved in that and maybe collaborate and ask questions. Unfortunately, in a traditional workflow, they would have a potentially a PDF sent to them, and it would take a long time to get communication backwards and forwards. So one of the really cool things about online collaboration now is that those teams that are invited to that tender workflow can actually ask questions inside of the app and inside of the specific requirements, rather than it being abstract and disconnected and maybe either scribbled on a PDF or written in a completely external system. So keeping all of that together is very important. And then when we look at the appointment workflow, we're selecting a lead appointed party and they will start to include responsibility. All of this is set up inside of the scope with the responsibility matrix, the task information, and the master information delivery plans. And
Yeah.
the importance here.
Yeah, teams can visually understand the milestones or the BIM uses within this module. They'll be able to put the list of what items are required, whether they're elements or even documents, to accomplish those specific goals, what information is required, and who's responsible. So that's one of the most important things to include. Also, the level of information need, being able to specify how much effort is needed in these elements or documents and what specific information. So if you need to get granular, for those very specific owners or needs for those BIM uses, this is where you can do that very easily.
Absolutely. The new 17412, really, really powerful way of being very much more prescriptive about what you're asking for so that you can then check it later on. And then the task list. So having task information delivery plans here, we can see the three from the architect, the mechanical engineer, and the landscape. Was that right? Landscape. All of these now summarized and understanding what they're delivering, when they're delivering it, how it's going to be classified and coded in that delivery as well. It's great having all of this in one place, but what about when you want to appoint somebody? One of the really, really key parts of the workflow is not overloading people and being much more purposeful when you are asking for things. So a great way of asking in this regard is to filter specifically per appointment. The example we're seeing, we're choosing milestones, so an information delivery milestone or purpose, and also a team, potentially a task team, that is then going to deliver a specific output. So we saw in the original intro where you can create these PDFs. These PDFs form the contract, the appointment documents, and much more targeted for each of those appointments. So we've talked about what happens to get people on board, and there are so many more videos and documented workflows that we will be sharing to unpack all of this. Okay, we know what we need to deliver. Let's mobilize a team. Let's make sure that we're actually getting to do, so there's no blockers in the way. Make sure that everyone understands and tracks the responsibilities and the handovers. Make sure that then we can validate and verify that we are meeting those requirements and that we are learning at the end of the day. So Louis, how do we manage the updates and status at work?
Yeah, well, each team has a certain permission level. So they can filter for their own scope of work. They can filter for their own teams, see tasks that are in within a certain time frame, and make those progress updates themselves. Typically, a modeler or someone who's editing the model would progress those tasks and get them to a point where a checker can then verify level of information need, all connected to the model. And we do have an integration with BIM 360. And it really helps ensure that we meet expectations from the original document and we provide better quality models.
Yeah, linking it to the requirements inside of the same workflow is extremely powerful to make sure that you're not missing things along the way. Teams know exactly what the tasks are, and you can understand when they're delivering exactly what they're delivering, and then being able to show it visually to be able to understand what is checked, what has been procured, what is on track, what is behind. Visualizing that status is really important. So we looked at the workflow from assessment of need and building that tender, that exchange information requirement, that then gets a response or many responses, gets selected, and then gets delivered. This is an introduction, and we will unpack every single one of the templates and how to use them, how to deploy them, how to get better results on your project. Let's just have a quick summary. We've covered a lot. There are lots of tools that help us to BIM, to create models, to understand them and to use them. But managing those standards and managing the workflows and managing the process, unfortunately, sometimes is on business management tools rather than BIM management tools or information management tools dedicated to this workflow. The unfortunate nature is that it's disconnected, usually from each other and mostly from the BIM workflow. So what we've done is created an integrated and more efficient workflow that's connected in a cloud-based environment and building all of those templates into it so that it makes it easier for teams as well. Lots of templates to get started. Being able to create and manage all of those documents online and be able to use these collaboration tools for commenting and restricting access and providing access when it is actually the right time and being able to control what's shared and what's published for authorized use. Having that in a combined with a tool and a process in the same place, being able to filter for those appointment documents, store all of those appointment documents inside of that same project so we haven't got a bunch of different documents going everywhere, being able to verify against those contractual requirements when the model or the deliverables, whether it's 2D drawings or documents are delivered for each of the tasks, and being able to also provide input for the teams that are developing the platform and the templates and become part of that review team as well. These are all some of the benefits that we would love to share with you